Have you ever paid $60 million for a pizza? Well, one programmer in Florida has. In this video, you will learn the basics of cryptocurrency, about its history, and how the price of a cryptocurrency is determined. What's going on, guys? Welcome to a new series about cryptocurrency. The first episode will be about the basics of cryptocurrencies. Click the subscribe button so you don't miss out the future episodes, which will come out in the next couple of weeks. This video is divided into four sections, which are the basics of cryptocurrency, history of Bitcoin, how the price is determined, and a summary. Let's get started. Bitcoin was the first decentralized cryptocurrency, and it was created by Satoshi Nakamoto. It is online money that you can buy, sell, and exchange for different stuff all around the world. There are over 1600 other cryptocurrencies besides Bitcoin, like Litecoin, Ethereum, Ripple, and so on. Comment down below what's your favorite cryptocurrency. The part crypto comes from how the cryptocurrency is protected, and the part currency comes from, well, the fact that it is a currency. As the crypto part of the name suggests, cryptocurrencies are very safe. Cryptocurrencies are a digital asset, there is no physical form. Unlike physical money, cryptocurrencies aren't issued by the government. This means that there is no inflation with cryptocurrencies because governments can't print more money as they wish. If you don't know what inflation means, simply put, it means that you lose your purchasing power. For example, if you have $10, you could buy one pizza for $10. But because of inflation, the pizza will cost $11 next year. This means that you can't buy it anymore, so you lose your purchasing power. One reason for inflation is the fact that dollar bills can be printed by the government. More and more bills are printed all the time, which makes the value of the dollar weaker. The maximum amount of Bitcoin that will ever be created is 21 million, and according to the book The Early Bird Gets the Bitcoin, that amount is estimated to be mined by 2024. So Bitcoin can't be just printed more and more until it's worth nothing. But how are cryptocurrencies created? Cryptocurrencies are created with mining. No, it is not mining gold with pickaxes, it is the system that processes creating the currency and verifying the transactions. To put it short, blockchain is a document that tracks all the transactions ever in the history of the cryptocurrency. Group of transactions that have happened in the past 10 minutes are called a block that the Bitcoin miners mine using not their pickaxes, but their computing power. The mining verifies the block, which prevents fake transactions. But why would anyone waste their computing powers to verify these blocks? Well, verifying these blocks can give you currency like Bitcoins as a reward. For example, one block contains 12.5 bitcoins, and every 10 minutes those bitcoins are given to the lucky miner. The lucky miner is the first one whose computer gets the right 64-digit number when verifying the block. I'll talk more about the blockchain in a future video, so that is all about it for now. But do you know how much 12.5 bitcoins is worth? While it doesn't sound much, at the moment one bitcoin is worth $11,800, so 12.5 bitcoins would be worth $147,500. Did that make you sharpen your digital pickaxe already? Cryptocurrencies are safe money because of this mining process. They are also kept in wallets like every other currency, but instead of a normal wallet, you store it in your computer. So, your computer is your wallet. This means that your cryptocurrencies won't be pickpocketed while you walk in the street, only if you lose your computer. Even though cryptocurrencies are very safe, this doesn't mean that they are stable. The price changes all the time, as you can see in this chart. In a couple hours, the price of Bitcoin went from $11,000 to $12,000. This means that Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are very volatile, but more about the price later in this video. Let's first move on to the history of Bitcoin, so you'll get a better idea on how cryptocurrencies became so popular. As I mentioned earlier, Bitcoin was the first decentralized cryptocurrency created by Satoshi Nakamoto. No one really knows who the creator Satoshi Nakamoto is. It is not sure if it is his real name or if it is just a made-up name. Bitcoin's co-founder was Hal Finney. He is not anonymous, but he also doesn't know who Satoshi Nakamoto really is. At least, that's what he claims. Anyways, in 2007, Satoshi Nakamoto started to develop Bitcoin, and in 2009, the first block, also known as the Genesis block, was mined. After 11 days, first transaction was made from Satoshi Nakamoto to the co-founder Hal Finney. On February 22, 2010, Bitcoin was first traded in the real world. A programmer paid 10,000 Bitcoins for two pizzas. this day is known as Bitcoin Pizza Day. As mentioned earlier, one Bitcoin is worth $11,800. So I really hope they were good pizzas, because they would cost $118 million today. I wonder if there were any pineapple on those pizzas. Comment down below what's your opinion about pineapples on pizza. Well, anyway, let's move on with the history of Bitcoin. On July 2010, Bitcoin's price raised from 0.8 cents to 8 cents. 5 days later, Bitcoin joined an exchange called Mt. Gox, and was slowly starting to become the Bitcoin we know today. Less than a month after joining Mt. Gox, Bitcoin was hacked and 184 billion Bitcoins were created. This problem is now fixed, and the cap on Bitcoins is back to 21 million. In 2012, Coinbase, the most popular cryptocurrency exchange, was founded. Coinbase kinda works like a stock exchange, but instead of stocks, you exchange Bitcoins. Coinbase made exchanging Bitcoin easy. In 2012, a Bitcoin bank also got listed as an official European bank. In the early 2013, the first Bitcoin ATM was created. Now, the price of one Bitcoin was already over $130. The price went down for a while because FBI shut down a criminal black market that used Bitcoin because Bitcoin hides your identity. In the late 2013, the price was already up to $503. Today, after Senate meeting about Bitcoin, the price rocketed to over $1,200. On 2013, companies like WordPress and Shopify added Bitcoin as a payment method, which increased the potential for more Bitcoin users. In February 2014, Mt. Gox lost 744,000 Bitcoins and everybody's money was gone with no trace of the criminals. In February 23rd, 2017, Bitcoin reached its all-time high value. One Bitcoin was worth almost $20,000. So imagine if you had bought Bitcoin with $1 back when it was 0.8 cents. You could have bought 125 Bitcoins. And if you would have sold those with the all-time high value, your $1 would now be almost $2.5 million. Nice. Still couldn't afford that $60 million pizza though. So, how is the price of cryptocurrencies determined? Because Bitcoin is decentralized currency, it means that it isn't issued by a central bank or backed by the government. Cryptocurrencies also aren't linked to gold or any other currency. Yes, you can buy Bitcoin with dollars, but you can't change Bitcoin to a fixed quantity of gold or dollars. This doesn't really matter, since you can't do that with dollars or any other currency either anymore. But things like inflation rates, economic growth, and so on don't apply to Bitcoin like they affect physical currencies. The price of the cryptocurrencies come from the supply and demand on the market. The supply changes all the time, since more currencies are generated all the time. Like Bitcoin is mined at a fixed rate until it reaches the maximum of 21 million Bitcoins generated. When supply is at a lower rate than demand, the price rises. The price is set by the market. The price of the currency reflects the expectations. When everyone has high expectations for the currency, more and more people want to buy the currency. Because demand is higher than the supply, the price will rise. When people think that cryptocurrency doesn't have potential in the future, they want to sell their currencies. This makes demand lower than supply is, so the price of the currency crashes. Because cryptocurrencies aren't linked to any money or banks, and you don't receive part of the companies like in stocks for example, the price of cryptocurrency is very volatile. Speculation in the market can make the price rise or drop hundreds of percentage in a month. There are also other factors that affect the price, like the amount of competitors and regulation for example. Let's imagine a worst case scenario that the government one day decides that cryptocurrency is illegal. Well, the price just crashed because no one wants the currency anymore. Competition in the crowded field keeps the prices down, but Bitcoin's high visibility gives it an edge over its competitors. Let's now summarize the video. Bitcoin was the first decentralized cryptocurrency developed in 2007. Cryptocurrencies are safe online money that can be used to buy, sell, and exchange for different stuff globally. There are over 1600 different cryptocurrencies like Litecoin, Bitcoin, and Ripple for example. Cryptocurrencies are created with mining, not with pickaxes but with computing power. Blockchain documents all the transactions. Mining these blocks verifies the transactions and rewards miners with currencies. This process makes cryptocurrencies safe. Even though cryptocurrencies are safe, they are not stable, but very volatile. The price is set by the market. When demand rises, the price rises, and when supply rises, the price falls. and the most important thing, you can buy two pictures with $180 million. Thank you for watching this video. Leave a comment down below what is your favorite cryptocurrency. If you are new here, click the subscribe button to improve your financial knowledge. I make two videos every week. Have a nice day and I'll see you later.